But tonight, ladies and gentlemen, something is happening, the likes of which you will not believe. We are meeting Mr. Only the Lonely, Mr. Running Scared, Mr. Crying, Mr. Evergreen, Mr. The Crowd.
You Mr. The Crowd.
Pretty Woman.
And watch your ashes.
Roy Orbison is coming to my house in Spanish Harlem
to write.
That's right. To write a song with me and the Mr. One and Only Bobby Tapper, the best looking man in rock and roll.
What if we throw up? What if we have a heart attack? What are we gonna do? We open the door. He was dressed in black. He had dark glasses on. That's right. He had dark glasses on. The man had the Beatles open for him. All right. Now you show me somebody that had the Beatles open for them, all right? You can take Ted, you can take Led, you can take the Rolling Stones, you can take all them people. They opened for Roy Orbison, all right?
And Benny, watch your ash.
Excuse me for just a second.
Oh, hey!
Wow, Mr. Roy Orbison.
Just
want to
tell you what I think of these two fellas, okay?
Oh,
Benny.
Well, first of all, I
want to
tell you that Roy
Orbison died.
You got to stay on for 1 second, Roy.
I mean, I used to tuck his fucking kids in at night. Him and Barbara were like a new family to me. I mean, how lucky could I be, you know? I grow up and my idol as a kid becomes my friend. I travel to Europe with him, all over America. I stay in his house with his wife and kids. He stays at my house and we write songs together, we sing together, we hang out together. He introduces me to Carl Perkins, Waylon Jennings, his next door neighbor Johnny Cash, the Rolling Stones. I mean, John Lennon called my house the night before he was killed to speak to Roy, and I answered the phone. You know, that was my life, and I was on my way to where I thought my destiny was going to take me, you know. And even Roy coming to me and telling me, you're screwing your life up, you gotta stop doing drugs. I mean, I loved him and I hugged him and I thanked him and I told him I would, but even that didn't stop me. And when he died, I felt like I never had a chance to apologize to him. So when Barbara called me to do the tribute, it meant everything to me. And when I realized that she had flown in Elvis Presley's band to back me up, I knew that she had forgiven me. And that night when I walked on stage, that's when I made my peace with God, my peace with Roy. And I knew that night he forgave me.
Just run and see what would I do if he came back and wanted you. Which one?